In our Establishing Quality Roadways video series, we've broken down the complicated web of road funding and identified the structural problems that divert the dollars we pay to the far reaches of Michigan, all while the roads in our community rapidly deteriorate. So we're talking with Trustee Julie Matuzik to discuss what we are doing at the township level to compete for the limited road dollars available and prioritize projects and compete for more road funding. It's important to know that in spite of the systemic problems in Lansing, we're actively competing for the funds that are available to improve our roads, but doing so comes with a pretty hefty price tag.
We all know there's no free money. When we compete for road projects, those projects require the township to match some portion of the cost. The match can be as high as 60% of the cost. Federal roads require a 10% match, and primary roads like Garfield Hayes or the Mile Roads usually require a 50% match. In the case of residential streets, the match comes directly from the residents. Since we don't have a funding source from Lansing like cities do, or from a dedicated road millage, all of those matching funds have to come from the township's general fund.
This is a chart of road projects completed in the township from 2008 to 2022.
In that time period, we've resurfaced over 40 miles of roads for a total investment of more than $121 million. The township has had to come up with $9 million, and residents have paid through the special assessment district process just under $5 million. So combined, we've paid more than $13 million, but it's brought us close to $27 million in road funding from other sources.
I would say that's competing hard for road dollars. While that investment came with a big hit to the general fund, we know we can't stop there. It's going to be a busy year for road projects here in the township.
In the next few years, about 13 miles of roads are on tap for a community-wide investment of $57 million.
Gratiot Avenue is a state road, so MDOT hits us for some lights and mast arms, but largely it's a state-funded project. For all the other projects, we need to come up with a little more than $6 million. While that's a big hit to our budget, it brings in another $22 million in road funding from Lansing.
$28.5 million combined, and with Gratiot, that means more than $57 million going to work fixing Clinton Township roads. This is the most aggressive year I think we've ever seen, but it comes with a big hit to the general fund.
Let's talk about federal dollars. These are the funds we need to go after. Why are these federal projects so important?
The short answer is the match. Federally funded projects only require a 10% match, but these are highly competitive projects and they're planned years in advance.
Okay, so let's talk about Kelly Road and 14 Mile Road.
In both cases, we work with our neighboring communities, Roseville and Fraser. Splitting these projects, the cost is only 5% to us and 5% to the other communities.
It's great for Clinton Township that this work is getting done, and it's long overdue. But I want to shift gears and talk about our new scoring matrix. The agencies that control our road funding ask us what road projects we would like done. Sometimes those calls for projects come years in advance, and sometimes we receive almost no notice. So that means we need to be Johnny on the spot and get those proposals in quickly, but we also want to make sure we do it fairly.
The Establishing Quality Roadways Committee has developed a tool we can use to determine, based upon data, which road projects to submit. No more arbitrarily picking this road or that road.
We now score roads by looking at a number of factors. We look at the condition of the road, which are our PASER ratings. We look at traffic volumes, crash data, where underground utilities are located, where essential services like hospitals, schools, and parks are located, and where roads have flooded in the past. We now factor in all of these considerations.
These are all important considerations, but the fact remains that we need more dollars from Lansing to address the roads in our community and throughout all of Southeast Michigan.
We need people to contact legislators. Visit our About Roads page on clintontownship.com, where you can find more informative videos and how to contact your state legislator with our easy-to-use fillable form. Let's make our voices heard and establish quality roads here in Clinton Township.